have any comments about Sloan wanting a rematch?
Sloan wants a rematch with me? Sure, I'd love another opportunity to treat her like a rag doll. Get him, Riea!
Ladies and gentlemen, in the corner to my left, from Nanaimo, British Columbia, Sloan! And introducing her opponent, in the corner to my right, from the ghettos of Prince George, Riea!
The action picks up right away. Sloan just going to work on Vaughn Slasher. Right before the bell. Big knee right to the face. Brings her out of the corner. Sloan off to a very fast start. Drops an elbow. Gets a two count.
Absolutely incredible speed by Sloan in the beginning of this matchup, Ojos. She came out firing on all cylinders.
No doubt about it. The women really bring a lot of physicality to the ring.
Ooh, a devastating move in the corner there by Riea. Using her power.
I don't think I'd want to be caught in a dark alley and see Miss Vaughn Slasher on the other end, that's for sure.
Winning predicament here, but Riea managing to kick out a dark alley. Absolutely not. The ghettos of Prince George, definitely not.
Absolutely. Sloan, though, really fast start. Oh. She's got her locked in an arm bar right now.
Sloan going to work on that arm, trying to wear down Riea Vaughn Slasher with a submission maneuver.
Oh. Really? You know what, Sloan's got a really versatile mat game. Obviously, the training that she had at Landstorm School really paid off, and the technical aspect of her game is really quite sharp.
Absolutely, but we can see there the power of Riea Vaughn Slasher using the leverage from that armbar to lift Sloan right up and drop her right down.
Well, she's not afraid to brawl with anybody.
Absolutely not. Oh my goodness, a devastating takedown and a big kick to the face. That can't feel good. I hope the dentist is free tomorrow. That might be a tooth or two in the audience there. Nice little souvenir for fans. Riea now taking advantage of the ropes.
There you go, taking liberties. She's not afraid to do that. Whatever it takes to win.
Absolutely, and there she goes again, using her power, using those ropes, torquing and twisting.
Maniacal, that's what she is.
Maniacal, absolutely. She's vicious.
She'll rip, she'll tear, she doesn't care.
By any means necessary, definitely Riea Vaughn Slasher looking for a powerhouse move here. She might, but Sloan managing to roll out of that one.
Didn't get all of it, but enough.
Slow and going for the pin there, but Riea managing to get her shoulder up. This match will continue.
Absolutely.
It seems that Riea Vaughn Slasher is complaining that her head hurts. Or maybe she was just playing possum. That was downright dirty. Now delivering some vicious chops to Sloan there in the corner.
Absolutely. Nice shot in the corner. Working the solar plexus.
Oh, absolutely devastating chop. I heard that one all the way back here at the broadcast booth.
Definitely got her attention. There's no doubt about that.
Got my attention, let me tell you.
She missed it. Oh,
ooh,
solid.
Some hard shot to the chopper.
She's getting her. Like a freight train coming out of the corner with
choo,
that clothesline.
Oh, my God.
I definitely wouldn't want to be on the receiving end of one of those.
Oh, definitely not. It almost looked like Sloan was going to take advantage with some hard shots, but it looked like it just angered Riea Vaughn Slasher as she came at her with everything she had. Oh, my
Went
goodness.
Went for a backslide. Came back. Ooh. Another neck breaker.
Incredible neck breaker and a pin.
Ooh.
pinning predicament. Again, though, maybe that's a result of not hooking the leg, Otos. I don't know.
You know what? That could be. Really, that could be. Absolutely. That was what it is. Hooking the leg definitely could make the difference. Like I always say, between the two and the three. Oh.
Oh,
and
absolutely.
See now what's happening. She hooked the leg. Von Slasher had an opportunity to get back up. Next thing you know, she's got her in the corner, working the solar plexus again.
Absolutely.
She's been taking.
Oh, my goodness. Sloan trying to exchange right hands with Riea. I don't know if that's such a great idea, as you can see the result.
Well, they're definitely both bringing the hurt in this match.
Lifts her up and puts her down. Devastating leg drop and a cover.
Still Sloan not quite out. Enough. Sloan definitely got a lot of heart. You know, she's showing it right now because Von Slasher's taking advantage of it.
Oh my goodness, look at this devastating submission maneuver. That looked absolutely painful, Ochos.
No problem resorting to cheating. Absolutely no problem at all.
Well, cheating is right. She's gone back to the ropes here. The referee having to initiate a four count, telling her to break it up.
You know, earlier in the match, it looked like Sloan, when she was kind of taken over with a headlock, she may have smacked her head, and maybe she's not showing the effects of that.
Oh, my goodness. Finally, Sloan showing the power.
Not
hitting
quite.
Hitting her with a clothesline, taking down Riea, going for the pin. It wasn't quite enough, but still an incredible clothesline by Sloan.
Absolutely.
Riea's still trying to get back up, and she's trying to exchange right hands with Riea again. Like I said before, I don't know if that's such a good idea. Oh, my goodness.
She's just pulled her momentum forward, and down went Sloan.
Absolutely. And Riea could be setting up for something devastating here. Looks like she's maybe going up to the top rope. Sloan is seeing stars. She's unable. Oh, she's rolling out Sloan now. And Riea wasn't paying attention. Sloan managing to roll out with some huge right hands. Hooks the neck. Could be, might be. Oh, my goodness. Right off the top rope.
It might be cold outside, but inside, it's Sloan season right now.
Absolutely.
Look at both of them down on the mat. The ref's counting. They've both pulled out all non-stop action since the get-go.
Sloan with a huge back elbow and a clothesline, taking Riea down twice. She has her in the corner. Oh my goodness. We've seen this in past bouts.
Sloan is on the offensive right now.
She is indeed. Sloan is fired up. She hits the trifecta. Oh my goodness, she's going for a pin. How did Riea kick out of that? It looked like she was on Dream Street.
Well, you know what? Von Slasher is a tough, tough cookie.
Absolutely. Oh
Spins
my goodness,
are over.
Sloan rolling out of a very devastating situation.
Double chicken wing face buster.
Oh my goodness.
This could be it.
There's a cover.
Couldn't quite get the three count.
Definitely had the leg hook that time, but
she's definitely showing the signs of fatigue. This match it's been a barn burner.
Oh, look at that. Riea out of nowhere using those legs to take down Sloan, and now she has control again, looking to set up for a very painful submission. Oh my goodness, what is this? What is this, Ochos?
I don't know what you call that, but she's in a world of hurt right now. Oh, it stomps her down.
Well, she looked like she was swaying back and forth. If I had to call it something, I would say rock-a-bye, baby. And now she's going for the cover again.
I can't even believe what I'm seeing right now.
Sloan managing to get her shoulder up off the canvas in the nick of time. This matchup will continue.
Absolutely, no doubt about it.
Both of the competitors look to be suffering some injuries in there in the ring.
I'm telling you, Sloan's got a lot of heart.
Absolutely, couldn't agree with you more. Off the rope, going for the clothesline.
Duck again.
Duck.
Oh.
Huge knee right to the gut of Sloan, and she is down again. Riea could be looking for something huge here. Oh, my goodness.
Looked like it rattled her a bit. Grabbing the back of her head.
Yep, absolutely.
And now
Riea could be going upstairs. She is. Oh, my goodness. And a cover. Three. This matchup is all over, Ochos.
Sloan Slasher picks up the victory, but you know what? Sloan gave it everything she has.
Man, I didn't think you'd win. I know I said either man could win, but I really didn't think Habico was going to pull that one out last week. So now it's set, the marquee, the main event. Your peer wrestling champion, EO Mike Becherer versus Habico. And every week now, I've been hearing, he's on every week. This guy's just building a follow. He comes out, who am I? And they all yell, Habico. Who am I? Habico. Who am I? I am the pure wrestling champion, Eddie Osborne. I am 16 years deep in here, and I am not losing this pure wrestling championship next week. I love the guy, but I love my championship just a little more.
Ladies and gentlemen, this contest is scheduled for one fall and is for the PWA British Columbia Championship. Introducing to my left, first the challenger, weighing in tonight at 282 pounds, from Nanaimo, British Columbia, BJ Laredo! And introducing to my right, he is the reigning and defending PWA BC champion, weighing in tonight at 217 pounds, from Glen Falls, New York, TJ Harley!
Definitely be an interesting matchup. TJ Harley, PWA BC champion, up against BJ Laredo, who is one tough cookie. 282 pounds of rhino. You definitely don't want to make that guy angry. You know, TJ Harley, naturally, it just seems that people don't want to like the guy.
And excited to be calling the action with you. Very excited for this PWA championship matchup.
Well, you know what? The action's hot and heavy tonight. I'm really enjoying the fact that TJ Harley's coming out here, and maybe he's going to get that darn fanny pack knocked off once and for all, because he's a huge fan of fanny packs. I don't think the fans are a huge fan of TJ Harley.
Absolutely, and TJ Harley, of course, having a lot of experience with PWA. He has wrestled for PWA Ontario, and now he's out here on the West Coast wrestling in British Columbia, and it didn't take him long to capture gold, as he is now the PWA British Columbia champion.
Definitely, he won it in this building, and strangely enough, I'm pretty sure that he used evil ways to do just that. Crowd definitely behind BJ Laredo in this match.
And absolutely interesting to mention, he debuted in 98. TJ Harley has been trained by Carl the Duke and Otto Von Erich.
Well, he's in there right now with BJ Laredo, who is undoubtedly probably the strongest guy in PWA right now.
I definitely wouldn't count BJ out of that department. BJ is definitely a powerhouse. He has the ability to hit that suplex out of nowhere. Case in point, he might be going for one right now. Look at him. Look at the power of BJ Laredo just picking TJ Harley up and moving him across the ring like that.
Look at that. BJ pinched him on the cheek as to say, I got you, buddy.
A little bit of an intimidation factor there by BJ, showing his dominance over TJ, mocking him, if you will.
I definitely think when I look at TJ Harley, I think to myself, nobody throws a better tantrum in wrestling.
Absolutely. Agreed 100% here, Rojos.
Look at this. BJ's nice and confident, allowing him to put the headlock on.
Do you think he allowed him, or do you think TJ Harley just has that much speed? Oh!
I'm pretty confident he allowed him the way that he just flew off of him.
Well,
like
TJ Harley going for a shoulder tackle, and he just bounced right off of the brick wall that is BJ Laredo. And you can tell he's definitely frustrated, possibly a little surprised and scared.
Well, you know what? I'm pretty confident that TJ Harley's not too happy to be in the ring with him right now.
I can't imagine anybody would be.
Absolutely not. That is one big boy.
Oh, you betcha. He has definitely not been late for supper.
Could we have a test of strength here right now?
And I think this is incredibly foolish on the part of TJ Harley. Moments ago, trying to go for a shoulder tackle and just bouncing right off. Now he wants to do a feat of strength with the man?
If I was BJ, I mean, I wouldn't trust TJ Harley as far as I could throw him.
And he just might do that too, Ochos. You can see the height advantage of BJ Laredo trying to force TJ Harley to reach for it, and now just completely crushing the arm of TJ Harley.
Oh, nice kick. Shot to the back. Oh, that was a little low there, ref. He got him right.
Well, it was definitely a move of desperation. You can see that BJ was breaking the hand of TJ Harley.
Every time Harley's in the ring, I think there's desperation. He'll do anything to win a match.
Oh, absolutely agree. You won't get any arguments out of me.
But right
TJ
now,
is turning around. Some hard right hands on a chop in the corner. And you know that TJ's feeling that sting. Oh, mama.
Well, Laredo's been known not to follow the rules a time or two in his career.
Some hard chops. Another devastating hard chop. He might be going for a chop in every corner. Could he? He might be.
He's working him over right now.
The final corner, Ochos. Is he gonna get it? He's asking the fans to quiet down. He wants to hear this one echo throughout the building. I think the fans are the very far back for that one.
Harley's in a lot of trouble right now. Forgive me, watching him fall down like that was quite entertaining.
A hard kick to the face by BJ Laredo. Oh my goodness!
I've seen him win a few matches just like that.
BJ going for a cover, but it wasn't quite enough as TJ Harley managed to get his shoulders up. And after that much weight crashing down, I don't know how.
I'm not even sure what Icarus is really needing to be out here for. He's just a distraction right now.
Exactly, Ochos. Exactly. You said it yourself. TJ Harley will do anything to win a match.
Just like that, the tide's turn. See, and this is really where TJ starts to shine.
Oh, look at that. TJ Harley had a fish hook in the mouth of BJ Laredo that hadn't been out using the ropes to his advantage.
Well, he definitely lives by that model, win if you can, lose as you must, but always cheat.
Absolutely. If he's not the dirtiest player in the game, he's definitely the dirtiest player on the West Coast, I'll tell you that much.
No doubt about it. PWA BC champion, and you know what? He takes that title very seriously.
Oh my goodness, Ochos, look at that. TJ Harley using the bottom rope to his advantage again, catapulting the throat of BJ Laredo right into the bottom rope.
Absolutely. You know what? It's ugly, but it works. He just gets down there, and he just lays the beating to him, right?
Huge leg drop and a cover. Only a two count. Somehow, BJ managing to get his shoulder up again. Well, absolutely. You know, if you go to work on the throat of your opponent, if he can't breathe, he can't wrestle.
Absolutely. But you would be you would be a fool right now to underestimate BJ Laredo. Laredo's kind of got that style where it takes him a few minutes to get going, right? It's kind of like a train.
Oh, a near three count. Somehow, BJ managing to kick out.
Once again, Harley resorts to what he knows best, cheating.
Absolutely, Ojos. I know that BJ is definitely feeling some pain. You can see him holding the throat there.
Absolutely.
Oh, look at now, TJ Harley is going to work on that throat of BJ again, using the ropes to his advantage. If he keeps this up, he may possibly crush those larynx.
Well, he's definitely gone to work. You know, when most guys are sitting there working a leg, working an arm, he's sitting there working the throat, you know. The ref should really be stepping in right now and putting a stop to that kind of stuff. That's ended careers before. Look at that.
I think he's definitely trying, but not having much success.
That didn't look like that was on the chin either. Those are looking really deep, right into the throat.
I think it's definitely evident, definitely clear, that TJ Harley has picked a spot to wear down, and it's definitely not what I thought it would be. I thought he would go for the legs, but he's decided to take the... Here's a cover. And a kick out by BJ, getting his shoulders up.
It seems every tactic he's used at this stage is illegal.
Hey, you know what? If it works for you.
You know, he's just gone to work on BJ.
Some hard elbows right to the shoulder of BJ. Now he's going to work on that throat again. Briefing down on the neck of BJ Laredo.
You might want to check to see that's a choke. You know what, ref?
Has he got the chin or has he got it right by the Adam's apple? I can't tell. Look at the look on the face of TJ Harley. He's just vicious.
Absolutely. Yes, I think he's suffering there. There wasn't a lot behind those. And Icarus again. This is unreal. Oh, Harley
causing some interference, allowing TJ Harley to gain control again. What's he looking for? Oh, my goodness! We were discussing him going for the throat. He literally put his knee right into the throat of BJ Laredo and dropped him. Here's a cover.
Not quite enough.
Somehow BJ getting... The heart of this man is absolutely incredible. And it's that same heart that has made BJ Laredo a former VIPW champion.
Absolutely, no doubt about it. But look at this again. He's standing essentially on his throat right now. The ref needs to stop this.
Well, I think it's evident that BJ Laredo isn't going to be recording any record demos anytime soon.
No, he's definitely... And you know what? I know you're trying to be funny when you say that, but you know what? When it comes to the larynx, getting that crushed—that's that could end a career.
Oh, absolutely, Ojos. Oh, look what we can see here. Judas is cheating on the outside again.
You know, Judas really has no business being out there right now.
Absolutely not. You know, somebody should definitely tell him to M-square.
The odds are definitely stacked against BJ Laredo. You've got TJ in there that'll resort to anything to win a match. And then on the outside, he's got his minion essentially doing his dirty work when the ref's not looking.
Absolutely.
Uh-oh. The big rig's getting going again, though. They're not even hurting him.
Oh my goodness, look at BJ taking those shots to the head with a smile on his face, and now he has control. Huge right hands.
Oh, he went again.
Oh my goodness. Oh. BJ going for a huge right hand, but TJ Harley ducked and delivered a huge suplex.
That didn't even faze him.
It didn't even faze
Harley,
him.
Harley, isn't...
Oh my goodness. Oh, mama.
He darn near took his head off with that one.
BJ back up with clotheslines.
Up he goes.
And right, he's got him up on the shoulder.
Oh! That could be enough, a little taste of his own medicine.
Absolutely.
Come on, Laredo.
He's going to go for the cover here. How did he not get it? Oh,
I really, I thought he had him on that, at that time.
Absolutely, I do not know how T.J. Harley managed to kick out of that. I don't even think he has abdomens left. Another pin and another kick out.
I gotta say, you know what? All that's. I'm a little shocked. T.J. Harley actually had enough in him to kick out of there. It shows that there's a side to him there that is a little unexpected, you know.
Oh, absolutely. Well, I mean, in my opinion, you can't hold a championship and not have heart. And T.J. Harley definitely has heart.
Thanks for correcting me. That's really what I was trying to get at. But a guy like him, I don't like to say he has heart.
Oh, Joseph, going to the top rope here. This is a devastating place to be for two competitors that size.
Absolutely.
And you can see here that Judas is...
You can't really see it. There it is.
Oh,
Icarus has got him. Uh-oh.
Now BJ's got his hands on Judas. Oh! But T.J. Harley coming to the rescue of his little buddy. And a huge powerbomb off the top rope.
Once again, the numbers game works against BJ Laredo. He's essentially wrestling a handicap match here.
Oh, absolutely, Ochoa, absolutely. But you can't count BJ out. He's been in situations like this before. And a cover and a kick out. An incredible heart being displayed by BJ Laredo.
Definitely a lot of dexterity. What's next? T.J. Harley bringing him back up to his feet, which surprises me a bit. You'd want to keep that big hoss down. European uppercut. And another. He brought him back to his feet. Uh-oh, could be time. Could be time. Package pile driver.
Oh, my goodness. Judas is on the apron. What is he doing there? He has no business being up there. He's distracting the referee. He's distracting B.J.
Uh-oh.
B.J. off the ropes. TJ's got him in a roll up.
He had the tights too.
Three count.
Handful of tights. Icarus. Unbelievable.
And still, PWA British Columbia champion, TJ Harley.
Wow, another great episode of PWA Wrestling on Shaw TV is in the books. Riea Von Slasher proved once again why she's one of the best women's wrestlers around with her big win over Sloan. Also, BJ Laredo got robbed. TJ Harley remains BC champion with the help of Judas Icarus. Something tells me that BJ Laredo is going to be enlisting the services of longtime tag team partner Scott Steele, and a big tag team match is in their future. Next week may be our biggest episode as Haviko, the Cinderella story, takes on EO Mike Becherer for the PWA Championship. It's definitely a real David versus Goliath type feel. Also, Nathan Legacy goes one-on-one with Nolan James, which is going to be an absolute Donnybrook. We'll see you folks next week. Thanks for watching PWA Wrestling on Shaw TV.